Hello, my name is Ever Barbero, and I'm reaching out to you today to talk about WebWork. WebWork is an online homework delivery system. So for anybody that teaches or is taking a course where paper homework is required, online homework will make your life easier and help you learn more and faster. So there are several advantages of online homework. First of all, no paper, you save trees. You have instant feedback. That means that when you enter the answers, you immediately know if the answer is right or wrong. And if it's wrong, you can go back and work it out or ask friends, the TA, the professor, to help you until you get it right. The problems can be set up with partial answers. That means that instead of having only the final answer that sometimes the text will give you for odd problems or even problems, and if you cannot get that final answer, then you don't know what to do. In WebWork, you can set up the problems with partial answers, break it down into parts, and every time you solve a part correctly, then you advance until you have the problem done. Also, you can have a multiple attempt. That is, if you the system tells you it's wrong, you can have a number of attempts to get it right. If with all these features, really, you can always get a perfect score because the system is telling you what is wrong and you fix it and you move on. Also, you won't have to wait a week for a graded paper with mistakes and on a problem that you solved a week ago or more and you don't remember what it is. It will be recorded online, and that means that you always know during the semester what your grades are. And for the instructors, the great benefits are no papers to grade and no grades to enter into Excel. Okay, so here we have a web work on the server at West Virginia University. This is the address for the server. And we see the front page that shows the courses. The courses that we are teaching right now are several. We have here thermodynamics, fluids, intermediate mechanics, internal combustion engines, sophomore mechanics, and these two sites for composite materials, which is what I teach. So there are two sites because I plan to do two YouTube videos. This one I'm doing today, in which I will describe how a student would see web work in action. And later in another video, I'm gonna do this to show how the instructor set up the homeworks for the class. So if we wanna do that, then we click on this. And now we have to log in. So I'm gonna log in as a student. There we go. And so once the student logs in, is presented with a series of homeworks, which have been set up by the instructor in the same way the instructor will set up paper homework. That is, the instructor selects problems from the problems at the end of chapters of textbooks. So today I'm gonna be demonstrating with one of my textbooks. The textbook is this one, Introduction to Composite Material Design, 3rd edition. It's used for senior technical elective in aerospace, mechanical, material science, civil engineering, other engineering courses, even good mechanics, stuff like that. And as you all the textbooks, you know, they have problems. So if I go to the next page, you can see here, this is one page of the book, which is for chapter 3. And it says problems, and we have problems 3.1, 3.2, and so on, like all the textbooks. Well, the textbook has 158 problems at the end of chapters, and most of these problems have been incorporated into the website, and they are available to be called up by the instructor to set up the homework online. And okay, so now we go back to the site, and the first thing we see is that there is a bunch of homework, which I prepare for this demo. And each homework contains all the problems for that chapter. So if you have access to this site, you can see all the problems. And another thing that I want to point out is that some of the homeworks, say 1 and 2, are closed. That means that the due date is passed. And so now the students cannot work on them anymore. And as soon as the homeworks are, the due date is passed, then the answers become available. I'm going to show you later. So even if you get it wrong, then when the due date passed, you can get the answer. But we have some homeworks that we can work on. And for example, we have this bonus homework A, and it's open, right? February, and it's due on February 25. So we have 2 weeks to work on it. And so I'm going to open, and you see homework 1, homework A, and homework A says due 2:25 at this time. And then it has 3 problems. And all right, so then to start working on it, you just click on problem 1. And here's problem 1. So in this problem, we have a cylindrical pipe with diameter D, which is this, subject to internal pressure 5 MPa, which is there. The pipe is free to expand on the length so that only hoop stress sigma Pd over 2T is developed in the wall. Okay, all this stuff is explained. Use a resistance factor that you have to read the book to understand what it is, and a load factor alpha, also read the book. The material is 6061T aluminum, and I'm giving you the yield strength, 270 MPa, and the density, all right? And it says, calculate the minimum wall thickness and the resulting weight per unit length. So this is the first example when the problem, unlike in most paper textbooks, is not asking for the final answer, which will be the resulting weight per unit length, but it's asking you first the thickness, then the weight. And that is to help you, because you get the right the thickness, then likely you can get right the second answer. All right, so now the answers I put in because I'm cheating and I know the solution. And I put minimum thickness 37 and minimum weight 314. And one thing that you can do is you can preview your answers. For example, why? Because if you forgot, for example, to put the units and you preview the answers, it's going to say your answer doesn't look like a number with units. So it's about formatting. Preview is only about formatting. It doesn't tell you whether it's right or wrong. So now I say, oh no, it's got to be millimeters. So I put millimeters, and this was right, right? 314 kilograms per meter, and which was already done. And then I can preview again if you want. And then, okay, it's formatted correctly, but I don't know if it's right. To see if it's right or not, I got to submit. I submit the answers. And, oh, okay, it's correct. I got the answers correct. And here it says perfect because you got both answers correct. So 100% of that problem. So I'm done with that problem. And now we go to the next problem. And here we have next problem. This problem comes from chapter 2. Same pipe, cylindrical pipe. Now it says that it's free to expand along the length so that no axial stress develops in the wall. Only hoop stress develop. And this problem is more about materials. It says the pipe is hoop wound, and it's assumed that the fibers carry all the load. And assume the matrix does not contribute to the strength of the material. Apply safety factor R equal to 2. Consider only glass fibers from table 2.1. So table 2.1 is from the textbook. And it wants the minimum thickness and the fiber type. And I put this problem to illustrate selection questions I can ask. And okay, the minimum thickness I put in ahead of time because I'm cheating. I know the answer. And then I know this is going to be E-glass and it's going to give me right. But I want to illustrate something else. You see, many students like to do problems on basic units, which in this case would be meters, but it is often much better to work with millimeters. So if you work with millimeters, your answer will be 1.667. And if you put 1.667, but you put millimeters, and now you preview your answers, it's formatted correctly, and let's see if it's right. Submit the answer. Yes, it's right because the system understands units, so the answer, it might be inside the computer in meters or in millimeter, it doesn't matter, wherever you put, if the answer is correct, it will be accepted. All right, it's not forcing you to use some particular unit. All right, so we submitted, it says perfect. We got problem 2, then we go next, problem 3. Problem 3 comes from chapter 3, which is processing. That is how you make composites. All right, so chapter 1 is an introduction. Chapter 2 is about materials. Chapter 3 is about processing, how to make the material. So here we have a figure, this is a schematic of pultrusion. Pultrusion is one of the many processes that you can use to make composites. And so you can read all about it in the textbook. For now, in this problem, he's asking, what is pultrusion's main advantage? So you gotta read chapter 3 to find out what is the main advantage. So I know, I should know, right? It's high production rate, so I click high production rate. And then pultrusion's main disadvantage, I know it's only constant cross-section can be made. So it's a production method that is very fast, so the material is very cheap, but you can only make prismatic sections. And that's, you can learn by reading the book, and you click on there, and then you preview and you submit your answers. Okay, so now that you have all three problems, then we look at your grades. And we go here, and we see bonus homework A, which we just did, and it's 100%, score is 30 out of 30, problem 1, 2, 3, we all got right. And the grades for all the other homework, we can see here, so at any time during the semester, you know exactly how much grade you credit you have for homework, no question about that, all right? And so finally, you can go to user settings, and you can change your password like any other program, anything like that. Okay, with that, you have seen most of what a student will see from the site when they are using it to complete the homework throughout the semester. And if you want to read and look at all the problems, then you can contact me to request an account for the demo guest account. And I'll be glad to do that, but I have to ask some information to know who you are and why you want to do that. And finally, I planned, like I said, to make another video, which will show how an instructor operates the site to set up the homework for the students. Thank you very much for your attention, and I'll see you soon.